The Republican-led state house has resisted Medicaid expansion since its introduction under the federal Affordable Care Act. That dates back to the Obama administration. Lawmakers shot down a bill to expand eligibility as recently as this year. State Senator John Wick was among the Republicans to oppose the bill.
But we have opportunities here in South Dakota because of what we've done. And we want the marketplace, not the federal government, to be in charge of your health care. Please vote no. Thank you.
The bill did fail in the Senate, but with the matter now up to voters, Senator Wick is making a similar plea.
The three reasons I have on expanding Medicaid and not doing it would be, number one, there are going to be over 6,700 families that have private health plans through Obamacare on the silver plans. They will lose them immediately.
A quick explanation. The silver plan under the Affordable Care Act allows people who make up to 400% of the federal poverty line to get private insurance plans with discounts. By expanding Medicaid, people who make even less can be eligible for Medicaid instead. If those newly eligible people want to stay on the silver plan, if Medicaid is expanded, then they'll have to pay full price.
If you're on Obamacare and you use this exchange, the silver plans that are available for people, and I'm not sitting here bragging up Obamacare, believe me, I'm still a Republican, card-carrying good guy. If you're using that plan, you get a taste of what private insurance is. And there are some limitations down the road through everything, but you get a taste of more freedom, more possibilities. And when you go back on Medicaid, that's it. You hit 139% of poverty, you're sitting where you are at 99% now. You don't dare make another dollar or you lose your health care.
No cost health care, that is. But that's not Senator Wick's only concern.
As far as most of our surrounding states, we have the lowest wait times of any state in the upper Midwest. And the quality of care for the people who need Medicaid most will suffer if we expand it. I mean, it's just math. There's so many doctors and so much time and so many providers that accept Medicaid. And the third one is rural hospitals suffer the most. If you look at some of the states that expanded early, you're finding rural hospitals closing more in those states than in non-expansion states. And that's one of the other reasons I want to stick with this. The system that we have is not perfect, but it is far better than more Medicaid, setting prices, especially in rural hospitals, where if we can get private insurance, they negotiate their fees, they work with hospitals, and typically it's better off than somebody, you know, with the literal, you know, financial gun to your head saying this is what you can and can't charge.
We know the proponents of expanding Medicaid eligibility are pointing to rural hospitals that are at risk of closing, saying this helps them. You're saying they're more at risk with expansion. Can you help connect the dots for us a little bit?
Right now I'm working with a couple of people in Montana and North Dakota. Montana expanded, and their rural hospitals are not seeing a rosy financial picture. It didn't solve all the problems they thought it would solve.
Senator Wick is opposed to expanding Medicaid, period. That's true for most Republicans in the state house. But another lawmaker, Republican Senator Wayne Steinauer, worries about making Medicaid expansion part of the state's constitution. In fact, it was his bill to expand Medicaid that the state Senate blocked this year.
So you decided to bring a bill to expand Medicaid eligibility through the legislature.
Right.
Talk us through your thought process on that.
Well, my fear is that it's going to happen through constitutional amendment. And the Constitution is very inflexible in terms of our ability to change it. So once it's in the Constitution, should we want to tweak it or change it in the future, it'll be difficult for the legislature to do. And there is a phrase in that constitutional amendment that on the surface sounds just fine. It basically says, and I'm paraphrasing now, that you can't treat one individually different than another or a group of individuals different than another. But I'm here to tell you that I think morally, we have a much higher obligation to take care of kids, elderly, poor, and disabled individuals than we do those in between. So what Medicaid expansion is doing is taking care of those between 18 and 65. So those in favor of the expansion would probably tell you this is to prevent us from taking certain services away, mental health services, for example, from a certain group of individuals. That wouldn't be in my intention in the bill that I offered that was not successful. But here's the other thing it does, and I think this is probably more at the crux of the matter, is it prevents the state from having work requirements or co-pays. And so again, if the state ever found itself in a tough financial bind, you can change behaviors with co-pays. And so if you, is it fair to say maybe a person that smokes should have a contributing cost, or he should contribute to the cost of his health care a little bit more than a person that doesn't? Or is it unfair to say, gee, if you really are that able-bodied individual, and again, I'm a little cautious in saying that, is it unfair to say you should be going to school or you should be working at least 3 months out of the last 12 months? Those are work requirements that other states have put in place. But if this goes into our Constitution, we don't have that flexibility. Yeah. And why would we need that? Maybe to change the cost curve for the state of South Dakota in the future.
The cost of expansion to the state is perhaps the most common reason lawmakers oppose expanding Medicaid. But exactly how much it will cost varies widely depending on who you ask. The Legislative Research Council is a nonpartisan group that analyzes policy and helps state lawmakers. It estimates Medicaid expansion will cost the state roughly $750,000 a year over the first 5 years. That includes some of the financial incentives included in the federal American Rescue Plan Act for states that haven't yet expanded Medicaid. After the first 5 years, the Research Council expects expanded Medicaid to cost the state about $22 million a year.
But during a debate last month, Governor Kristi Noem used a much bigger number.
And looking 3-4 years down the road, we're anticipating that the annual cost for that Medicaid expansion ballot measure would be $80 million.
These costs also depend on the number of new enrollees under expanded Medicaid. That number could be as high as 67,000 people or as low as 22,000. Senator Steinhauer's opinion has evolved over the years. He believes expanding Medicaid is a moral imperative. He says the state should take advantage of current federal incentives while maintaining some legislative control. That's why he's wary of a constitutional amendment. But Senator Wick thinks there are other solutions to healthcare access.
The South Dakota legislature and the administration are working with creative ways to try and get health care to the people who need it. And you combine that with federal resources that are already available. There are three really good solid reasons to vote no. And if you sit down with me one-on-one for an hour, I can give you a million reasons to vote no.